In today's video, I'm going to talk about AEM and the different instance types, and then create some Docker containers for an author and publish instances, and another one for the dispatcher. So, let's start! Adobe Experience Manager is a content management system, which in a nutshell is an application that allows us to create websites to be consumed by end users. You might be familiar with other such applications like WordPress or Drupal, which serves the same purpose. A typical deployment would be comprised of two AEM instances, the author instance used for creating and modifying content, the publish instance, which serves the content, and finally, we have a dispatcher that is a static web server used for caching, load balancing, and some security purposes. We can configure an AEM instance to work as an author or publish instance by either changing the file name for the jar file or using the run modes to configure the instance. The jar file has a simple standard to configure your instance. Typically, you would type AEM or CQ as the first part of the name, then after the first dash, the type of instance, and then we define the port. AEM already has a default port for each instance, the 4502 for the author instance, and the 4503 for the publish. Once you start the jar file, it will create an instance using the name as part of the configuration. AEM also has a concept called run modes, which in just a few words allows us to configure or customize how an instance behaves. But for now, the important part for us is about configuring the instance types. For that, we only need to pass author or publish as the parameter. We're going to use a system property when starting the instance, which is one of the several ways of configuring the run modes. We also need to pass the port as well. The dispatcher module can be downloaded from Adobe's page by selecting the dispatcher that matches the version for your Apache server. If you uncompress the zip file, you will see that it has the Apache module, some instructions to configure Apache to use the dispatcher, which have been already applied into the httpd.conf file, and a folder with some default configurations. I will take the default dispatcher.any and make some little changes so that the dispatcher knows where the publish instance is. So, for the containers, I'm going to create a couple of things. A base image, which should have everything I need to reuse for the author and the publish containers, and another one for the dispatcher. By the way, you will need to have access to an AEM instance. I will be using Docker Compose to start our AEM instances. Inside, I already defined the three services and their respective folders, one for the author instance, one for the publish one, and one last service for the dispatcher container, which also depends on the publish service being started. For the base image, you will need the AEM jar as well as the license.properties file on the same folder of the Docker file. I'm going to start from an Ubuntu image, define the default directory, install Java 8, which is one of the supported versions for AEM. Then I will copy the license and the 6.3 jar that I have locally, and finally I will unpack the jar file so that we don't have to waste time doing it for the other images. Finally, just build the image. Given that we already have a base AEM image with everything that we need, creating the author and publish instances should be pretty simple. In this case, to customize the way each type of instance behave, we will need to use the run modes and port configurations described earlier. So, for the author instance, we start from the base AEM image, expose the 4502 port, and define that this container should call the jar that we have from before and pass author as the run mode, and also the port that this AEM instance should be listening on. For the publish instance, we do the same, but in this case, we expose the 4503, the standard port for the publish instance, define the run mode as publish, and again pass the same exposed port to AEM. For the dispatcher, we need the httpd file with the dispatcher module already configured, following the instructions from the readme file, and a dispatcher.any file also already configured to point to the publish instance. For the container, let's use an Apache image as a base, define the working directory, download the dispatcher module using the add instruction, unzip the file and add the dispatcher module into Apache modules folder. Then copy our local dispatcher.any configuration file, copy a modified version of the httpd.conf file that already has the configurations needed, and that's it. Now that we have everything ready, let's discuss three different ways of starting our new containers. First, let's start the author, publish, and also the dispatcher containers by typing docker compose app. This might take a while. Okay, let's start just one container, also using docker compose app. For this, just specify the name of the service after the command. And finally, let's just use the docker command. For this, we need to change into the directory in which the docker file is located, build the image by giving it a name, and then start the container using the name we previously defined, and map the local with the container's port. One thing that we are missing here is that we need to configure the replication agents so that we can activate pages from the author instance into the published one and also clear the cache. I will discuss how to configure this in a future video. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you like the video, please hit subscribe.